Ladies and gentlemen, thanks a lot for your appearance.
No sound.
Okay, once again, thanks a lot for your appearance. Big interest and in a Swiss football stadium. I give the floor to the elected FIFA president, Joseph S. Blatter. Please, Mr. Blatter.
To say that it's a good day for me or for FIFA, this would be totally wrong. Thank you for coming to this press point that finally is a press conference with such a great audience. The last time we had a lot of audience here was in the same room, was at the presentation of the candidates for the World Cup 2010 with one personality who was sitting here, Mr. Mandela. Mr. Mandela was speaking about humanity. And humanity is where we are in our world. In our world of football, in our world of the geopolitical situation, and humanity needs or has no other signification than respect each other. Human beings to be respected. And I say that because celebrate humanity through football was the slogan of the World Cup 2010 and was created by this great humanist, Nelson Mandela. I say that today here because I just received a little bit later than you, and this is a question I put somewhere, why the media are informed before the persons directly involved or accused. But this is not a question that we are going to debate anyway. We are not in a debate. Sorry that I speak English, but I think the majority of the audience here, they understand at least my English, which is based on a specific footballistic and a little bit humanistic vocabulary. I have with me my daughter, Corinne. She can make any translation if this would be needed. But she's laughing, that's a good thing. And you know, Thomas Renkli is the only man in these past days. He was supporting me. I suppose that another supporter here is also somewhere in the audience. But coming back, what has happened? Ladies and gentlemen, let us say that I'm really sorry. I am sorry that I am still somewhere a punching ball, but I'm sorry that I am, as president of FIFA, this punching ball, and I'm sorry for football. I'm sorry for the Fédération Internationale de Football Association I'm serving now more than 40 years. I'm sorry for that. I'm sorry for the 400 plus FIFA team members that are working in FIFA. I'm sorry about that. I'm sorry. But I'm also sorry about me, how I am treated in this world of humanity, of humanitarian qualities. And I have organized, or I asked to have a press contact and press conference after, for different reasons, but specifically, specifically for when I knew that there will be a decision by the tribunal of the ethics committee on this very day. You can identify me as an optimist. Together with a Swiss lawyer, well known, Maître Lorenz Erni, we saw that we have convinced the panel of the tribunal with Mr. Eckert in the chair about this the situation which was created about the payment by the FIFA, I'm FIFA president, but by FIFA, to Michel Platini, for an ongoing contract which was never terminated, but where still there is something due, that we would be now in a situation that is clear and a clean sheet of situation. Because we are in a so-called oral contract or gentleman agreement, and this gentleman agreement was made already in 98, in just after the World Cup in France, where Mr. Platini approached me, and I approached him because we worked together there, and said he would like to work for FIFA. And I said, it is wonderful if you come to FIFA. He said, but I am a very expensive man. Je vaux 1 million de francs suisses for per year. I said, that's okay, but we cannot pay you now. Because we cannot pay you now. We pay you part and then later. But what astonished me now, if I'm going to the decision of this adjudicatory chamber today, it is a summary decision, but still, is that they deny the existence of such an agreement. And this agreement was indirectly or directly confirmed by two meetings of the UEFA Executive Committee, the one in Sweden, and the other one here in Zurich in December 98, or we are in the year 98, and here in Zurich it was an international executive meeting, because the next day we had FIFA executive meeting, and there are people that were spoke about, can you imagine, the Europeans, they like Platini because he was supporting me, they don't like me because I took the presidency on the 8th of June, and they said, can you imagine, and this is written down, can you imagine that Platini is going to work for FIFA for 1 million, and he never, the value, he will never, he's nothing, this Platini, he's nothing because they would be paid 1 million. But they have confirmed that discussion was taken, later was held. And also one of the men from France, who is actually in the chair of the organizing committee for Euro 2016, le préfet Lambert, he could recollect this discussion. So therefore, we have to prove, or we prove, that this was not only known by Platini and me, and therefore, agreement existed. And nowadays, this adjudicatory chamber has denied that existed, and therefore that the two million Swiss francs by letter from Platini to me or to the finance department of FIFA, and that we said this is due to Platini, and it was paid to Platini, it went through the finance committee, it went through to the executive committee, to the FIFA control committee, two committees and the Congress. It was registered. It has been done in good terms. That as this contract or the contract never existed, this is a donation. This is a gift. They have avoided the word of corruption because they took it out at the beginning of the meeting. But still, that I have given this money to Platini to buy UEFA, to buy the votes for the FIFA 2011. Now here, you journalists, most of them journalists, you have followed the history of FIFA, then you cannot change the history of FIFA. The election in 2011 was made against the opposition of UEFA. And you will remember at the time when the elections took place, there was two members of the UEFA associations, one from the British Islands. They came out and said, order, we want to change the agenda of the meeting of the Congress of FIFA. There shall be no election at this time. And there was an election. By the way, there was only one candidate against me at the time. This was Mohammed bin Hammam, who was he was twice not a candidate. First, he was withdrawn by his own country, where he was proposed. It was Qatar. And secondly, he was 2 days before the election, he was suspended by, at that time, Ethic Committee of FIFA. So, and this is on these allegations that I have given gift for not saying corruption, but I have given a gift to Platini because this arrangement and contract, also in the FIFA books, you can have written and oral contracts. It is for this reason I am now suspended 8 years. Suspended 8 years. But I will fight. I will fight for me and I will fight for FIFA. Suspended 8 years for what? So therefore, immediately, and I spoke with my lawyer this morning, who definitely was not surprised that the notification of the decision was first made to the media and later to those they should receive it. He's not surprised because communication in this ethics committee is an example how you shall not do it since the beginning of this matter. And then I'm suspended 8 years. And I just heard as well, because it was not in my decision as well, Michel Platini. And can you imagine what has been in the books of the accusation? That is because Michel Platini and myself, we were asked separately. We have never had a contact in between. But the first day when this happened, it was in a meeting here in July in Zurich, and we were separated, we couldn't speak together, and we have given the same answer about this agreement, the same answer. And in the books now it's written, it's not relevant what the two presidents have said separately. You know what that means? That we are liars. He's a liar and I'm a liar. And this is not correct. It is not relevant what the two have said. Not relevant what the two have said. So therefore, with my lawyer, Mr. Ernie, Maître Lorenz Ernie, he is putting into question all the what is right and what is wrong, and the justice, this is the sporting justice. I will use the sporting justice now to go forward. We go immediately once again to the appeal committee. We go to the TAS, Tribunal Arbitral du Sport. we go also to that's another to the to Swiss the rights of Switzerland. I'm a Swiss citizen. You know, if in the Swiss law you would be suspended for 8 years, you must have committed something very, very, very important. Very important. And therefore, the only thing that they could and they would have done, this ethics committee, the adjudicatory chamber, is to say, yes, if this arrangement has existed, and it existed, it's still existing, you should have put it somewhere in your books. I agree to that. I agree to that. But this is administrative and financial, let's say, proceedings, and this has nothing to do with ethics. So it is just if in the finance or administrative duties there was an error, but this is nothing to do in the ethics regulations. Voilà, ladies and gentlemen, that I wanted to say here concerning this decision, which has touched me. But I come back. But I just want to say that already, the first decision to suspend the FIFA president, without the hearing of the adjudicatory chamber, we were only heard by the investigatory chamber, and in human rights, and in all countries where human rights exist, that in a tribunal, and even it is in FIFA's court of disciplinary, it is also in the Olympic Charter, it is also in the Charter of the United Nations, to be before you are sanctioned, you have the right to be heard. I speak about this first decision. This first decision has already put a new tsunami in FIFA. Inside FIFA, people couldn't understand why the president of FIFA, at a sudden, he suspended. Secondly, it has created a lot of collateral damages outside of FIFA, in the families. My family, with Corinne here and his daughter, they were mobbed about that. Friends were mobbed. The village of FIFA, of FISP, was in a crisis because they said, what do you have as a representative there? And this is to be condemned before justice is made. And you remember that the accusation chamber has already said that Platini and I, we would be suspended for lifetime. Now they come a little bit back. But it shows that something is wrong in this system. Something is wrong. And that's why I have to fight to put again the rights on the place. And I repeat, I regret that I'm this punching ball there. I regret for my organization that I have served with heart and conscience during 41 years, but specifically I regret, and I'm for all the members, the team members working in FIFA. But saying that, FIFA was working well, is still working well, and I congratulate the Football Club of Barcelona for winning for the third time the FIFA's World Club competition. Voilà. Question. Thomas, you can proceed to some questions. I will try to answer the questions, but I don't answer twice the same question.
Now we pass the word on you. Please introduce yourself first, and just one question per journalist.
Yes.
You are sorry. I'm not ashamed that it has come to this. The ethics committee you founded has thrown you out of football.
No, I am ashamed about that. The committees exist and they don't go to the evidences they are presented. And I tell you, this committee has no right go against the president. The president of FIFA can only be revealed from his activities by the Congress. And in the next Congress, which is scheduled on the 27th of February, before going to the election of the Congress, of the new president, the former president, I'm still the president, even suspended, I am the president. The president must be relieved of his duties. Otherwise, you cannot elect another president. I'm not ashamed. I regret, but I'm not ashamed. I am ashamed if you go in depth what has been presented and how all this has been done with the support of you. You were there also to condemn this FIFA president at the very beginning. He's in corruption. He is the conscience. He should know that all the people they have been arrested, that it's his mistake. He has done everything wrong. I am not the conscience of the people that I cannot elect or that I cannot, let's say, nominate personally. I repeat that. I will always repeat that. I will always repeat that. And I am a man of principles, and these principles are, and I still go on, that never take money you have not earned. Secondly, pay your debts. But now they are telling me that I tried to buy through Michel Platini votes for the 2011 elections. Now, this.
The lady, please.
Yes, thank you. Yes, I remember that. And you know that in China now, China has realized that football is this big the game as well. But I'm still of the opinion that football is the biggest and the most important game in the world. Football is the game that brings, in this disturbed world, that brings emotion and hope. And I am very much touched. I was very much touched that for the first time, football was attacked by so-called political or parapolitical entities when it came to this famous day in Paris where something should happen in a stadium. So long, football has never been attacked, and footballers have never been attacked, because football is coming back to China. China now is. We always say China is the future of what? But now with the new president that I had the pleasure to meet, Mr. Xi Jinping, I had the pleasure to meet, and now the football is doing a great job there, and a better job than I have done in the Olympics 2008. Because football had only one medal and all other sports had different medals. So they have abandoned a little bit of football, but now they are there, they are working well, they are working on a big contract with FIFA, and I'm sure that Chinese football will play a big part. Already your club team was playing for the third place in the competition in Yokohama now. Thank you.
Gentlemen over there.
Mr. Blatter, for the game from Dagblad in Norway, do you feel betrayed by the FIFA which you have created?
Betrayed by the FIFA.
Yes, betrayed. Yes, I think betrayed can be the right thing. But speaking about Norway, you're from Norway. In Norway, you know, we have started something, and I will tell you, I have already said that, but for time to time you forget it. When we came in this famous 2nd of December 2010, we had a dream, I have to say a dream. It was a reality, in fact, at that time, and it was not a written contract, but it was said that we will open the World Cup to two terms. It was in 2010. We had the World Cup in Brazil for 2014. And we said we go to 14. It's okay. So we go 18 and 22. And we will do it together. Why? Because we had the idea that in 2018, the World Cup should go to a country which has never had the World Cup in Europe, because in the eastern part of Europe, never the World Cup was there. It has been in England, the World Cup has been in Sweden, the World Cup has been in Spain, twice in France, twice in Germany, twice in Italy, everywhere, but never there. Okay, so this was a possibility, but was still open in the vote. The second one, we should make also, because I speak about Norway, they came before the World Cup 2010 in a friendly match against South Africa, Norway, and they have introduced something which later on we introduced in FIFA, and this is the handshake for peace. So in this idea for the handshake for peace, it was an idea, then we shall go for the World Cup 2022 to another powerhouse. If we go to Eastern Europe, we should go to the USA. Can you imagine if this would have worked out? We wouldn't be here today, I am sure. But it didn't work. It didn't work for different reasons, but we are here now. So your question, if I am betrayed by my... Yes, I think we have put in this ethics committee to work on the ethical, let's say, behavior. But if they deny an evidence and they try to build up something which is not true, because there is a principle first of all, they have to prove it. The tribunal has to prove it. But something what is not true cannot be proven. And if it cannot be proven, cannot be guilty.
Do you think the Qatar controversy is the reason why you are sitting there now? Is that what you were hinting about?
Qatar controversy.
Yeah, the Qatar controversy is something else. It came out because Qatar was then elected. Also, I have said one day also at that time when we made the decision for Africa, South Africa, the heir apparent of the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia, Prince Abdullah, who later became king and who passed away this year, he told me one day an Arab country should also have the World Cup. But we were a little bit surprised that it's the smallest Arab country that was in the context with four other contenders of the same continent.
Lady in red, please.
Herr Blatter, Frau Dörr, bitte ARD Fernsehen. Kommt Ihnen das manchmal in den Sinn, oder ist Ihnen das nicht in den Sinn gekommen heute Morgen, dass das jetzt der richtige Zeitpunkt wäre, die Verantwortung zu übernehmen für das Chaos bei der FIFA und sich zurückzuziehen?
Ich danke für diese Frage, aber ich habe ja die Verantwortung übernommen und habe mich am 2. Juni, habe ich gesagt, ich stelle mein Mandat zur Verfügung. Wir haben jetzt Zeit, einen neuen Kongress zu organisieren, einen Electoral Kongress. Wir müssen aber auch die Reformen durchbringen, die nicht durchgebracht wurden. Also ich habe mich zur Verfügung gestellt. Ich bin der scheidende Präsident, ich bin nicht der wählende Präsident. Also ich habe mich zur Verfügung gestellt, damit die FIFA sich richtig organisieren kann. Aber dann muss man mich nicht inzwischen mit solchen Sachen dann suspendieren. Dann kann ich ja meine Arbeit nicht machen. I just repeat in English what I have said. She was asking that it was not time for me now to withdraw. I put my mandate on the 2nd of June, I put it at the disposal of the FIFA by saying we must have a new electoral congress and we must put the reform, the remaining reforms into decisions. And we started with all that. But I cannot now be this president who had this idea to put his mandate at disposal and to bring FIFA to this 27th of May, of February, when they suspend me. So I cannot do my job, and the job as FIFA president.
Gentlemen in the back row.
En français, s'il vous plaît, bonjour, Arthur Elbachet de la radio Europe 1. Personnellement, vous, qu'est-ce que vous ressentez ce matin?
Excusez-moi, personnellement.
Qu'est-ce que vous ressentez, vous, ce matin?
Eh bien, aujourd'hui, d'abord, j'étais très triste. Triste. Mais maintenant, je ne suis plus triste. Maintenant, je suis combattant. Parce que ça ne va pas comme ça. Ça ne peut pas aller comme ça. Ce n'est pas possible. Ce n'est pas possible. Ce n'est pas possible, après 40 ans, on fait des choses comme ça. Ça ne va pas. Et ça ne va surtout pas quand on met en cause, et je le répète ce que j'ai dit en anglais, quand on dit que ce que M. Platini et M. Blatter a dit, ce n'est pas important dans le truc. Ça veut dire que nous sommes des menteurs. On nous présente comme des menteurs. Pour quelle raison on ne croit ni à M. Platini ni à moi? Et ça, c'est une question de respect aux personnes. Et c'est une question de respect à la justice. Tu ne peux pas condamner quelqu'un sans les raisons valables. Et maintenant, je suis condamné ou suspendu, Platini de même, mais ça veut dire que ce n'est pas fini. Donc, il y a toujours encore le fait qu'on peut aller, on doit redéfendre. J'espère que Michel fera la même chose. En tous les cas, moi, vous me voyez, moi, maintenant, je suis combatif. Je ne laisse pas là, ça. Pas pour moi et pas pour la FIFA. Parce que moi, le président élu, je voulais amener cette nouvelle présidence, le 27, là. On m'a coupé les vivres, on me coupe, je fais quoi? Alors je lutte pour restaurer mes droits, et je pense que jusqu'au mois de février, on aura le temps de le faire. Et je crois en Dieu, mais je crois en moi, et je crois aussi aux instances sportive de la FIFA et aux instances sportives que nous avons mis ensemble avec le CIO qui est le TAS. Les instances sportives interviendront que le 27, je serai président, je pourrai présider le congrès de la FIFA.
Et vous souhaitez la même chose pour Michel Platini?
Mais bien sûr, bien sûr. On est dans le même bain.
Vous avez expliqué, vous étiez d'accord, c'est un problème de comptabilité, vous auriez dû inscrire ces 2 millions dans le compte, vous ne voyez pas de problème éthique. Est-ce que vous ne vous êtes pas dit 1 million pour une personne, monsieur Patrick, vous avez dit je suis cher, est-ce que vous ne vous êtes pas dit que c'était éthiquement problématique 1 million de salaire, et pourquoi vous avez absolument voulu monsieur Patrick? Et la deuxième question, quand est-ce que vous l'avez vu, quand est-ce que vous lui avez parlé pour la dernière fois?
Bon, écoutez, madame, j'aime votre question pour savoir si éthiquement c'est possible $1 million, $1 million de francs suisses pour une star de football. C'était son prix. Je ne l'ai pas mis en cause. Comment je peux mettre en cause le prix d'une personne? Je ne peux pas. Par contre, je lui ai dit, la FIFA ne peut pas payer $1 million de francs suisses maintenant. On te paiera le reste plus tard. Lui, il a demandé le reste très tard. Ça, c'est son problème, ce n'est pas le mien. Mais la dette, elle existait. La dernière fois que j'ai vu M. Platini, quand on nous a sortis du comité exécutif de la FIFA, moi avec une escorte de police, et puis lui un peu moins, et puis on nous a mis dans une chambre, et puis on a commencé à parler, on nous a tout de suite séparés parce qu'on s'est dit pourquoi ils ont fait ça. On ne savait pas. Pourquoi tout à coup on met en cause le paiement des 2 millions? Voilà, madame.
Over there.
Jan Kostner, Bloomberg. Mr. Blatter, what does the CSS do differently from you? And what are the concrete legal steps in Switzerland to pursue?
My successor?
Yes. How, you know, what should he do differently from you?
Bon. listen. You or most here present, they know me. I passed now more than 40 years. It's it's, I would say, the adult age of a person, 40 years, he should not do more than 40 years, definitely. And I have said what was wrong with me is that at the end of the famous World Cup in Brazil, I should have said, and I should have listened to this girl here and to another lady, they said, now stop it. And I haven't done it because at that time, Michel Platini has already resigned to be a candidate president. And five other confederations have said, then you stay our president. Stay as our president because we have seen what the candidates they came in. But this would have been the right thing. But I cannot express qualities or non-qualities to my successor. There will be one. We have still four in the pipeline. And I don't know how the Congress will react. Now I have first to fight that I can be at that Congress. And as I am forbidden even to go to FIFA, I have no access to books or whatever. By the way, just for everybody, to suspend the president of FIFA and to impede him to go in a football stadium, it's the 26th of February, not 27th, thank you. But this is wrong because in the disciplinary code, this applies to players, coaches, and referees do not go to stadia. And they are suspended, but they can still practice with their teams. But they shall not go there when the matches are played. But to suspend the president of FIFA or other what you call high-level functionaries to say they cannot go to a football match, this is absolutely wrong. It does not apply. It does not apply to these persons.
Gentleman with the tie.
How do you think the Swiss prosecutors found out about this payment? Who do you think told them?
This is not a secret, because Swiss banks are obliged to notify to Swiss authorities since years now, since there is all this financial control to a Swiss organization which is called FINMA, and they are obliged if they feel that the payment is something high in a personal account, they have to. And so in 2011, Michel Platini received on his personal account by FIFA, not by me, by FIFA, these 2 million Swiss francs, and then they have given this information to the Swiss authorities. And only later on, the Swiss authorities have looked at that. That is also, yeah. Because all was done in the good regulations of Swiss law.
On the left side?
You said none of this would have happened if the United States had won the rights to the World Cup instead of Qatar. How can you say that when the ethics committee is made up mostly of European people, the judge who made this decision is a German? Or do you think the Americans are the ones that are responsible for your position?
No, the FIFA Ethics Committee at this time was composed by an Australian, by one of Papua New Guinea, and one from Uruguay, and I had a good impression on the panel, and I think my lawyer was clever enough to deny any gifts given. And this is what touched me, really, is that I have never cheated with money. And now I should have given 2 million just to buy votes. Votes from whom? From Europe? Finally, I got votes from Europe. I always got the vote from Europe in all the matters. And if you go backwards to the history, that you will also know that already in December and November 98, the European Executive Committee came together by saying, how can we get rid of this JSB. They never mentioned President Blatter in their documents. We have the documents. How can we get rid of JSB? It was 5 months after my election. How can we get rid of? And they tried in 2002 to get rid of me.
Well, sorry, why do you think this wouldn't have happened if the United States had won the World Cup rights?
I don't think that the Ethics Committee has some links with the United States. I don't believe that. I don't believe that. That the Ethics Committee of FIFA, I cannot believe that. That they are not good in communication, we have seen that. But I would not say that there is some pressure by somebody here. It is inside the FIFA, and I can not exactly identify if they wanted to avoid that Platini shall be the FIFA, the next FIFA president, or if they just wanted to give a kick to this non-comfortable or non-accepted FIFA president. I don't know. One or the other. Two questions.
Two more questions in the back. Yes.
La question, c'est que vous avez dit que reproche de Platini, etc. Est-ce que votre réaction de revanche contre Platini ou une réaction pour protéger la système contractuelle?
Rien pour
vous. Je suis une revanche contre Platini.
Ah. Okay, this is just what I have mentioned. I do not, but for me, no, it's never a revenge against Platini, because I said and I stated before now all these decisions, television has asked me, do you feel that Mr. Platini is a honest man? I said he's a honest man, and I believe that he's a honest man. We have not always the same ideas. And he had another approach to the FIFA presidency than I have had. If it was, but never I had the idea to make something against him, because I would be a fool, because I am involved in this matter. So perhaps I'm not the most clever man in the world, but in this case, comme on dit en français, je suis pas un imbécile.
ESPN.
Quisiera pedirle, por favor, unas palabras en español, siendo que en nuestra región, en nuestro lenguaje, lamentablemente, muchos de los acusados, sobre todo de este tsunami, como lo ha llamado usted, tienen que ver. Las dos confederaciones, CONCACAF y CONMEBOL, eran quienes más los apoyaban, presidente. Y estas dos han sido tocadas muy fuertemente. Usted ahora ha sido suspendido. ¿Piensa que ha tenido una traición, que ha hecho elecciones equivocadas en sus relaciones? Usted por 40 años ha tenido las riendas de este juego. ¿Siente que se ha equivocado profundamente en alguna cosa que tiene responsabilidad?
No. ¿Can I answer in English?
No, please, en español.
En español, bueno. Ok. Bien. Sabes que todos estas personas que fueron ahora castigados de parte de las autoridades americanas son todos de la América del Norte o del Sur, de las dos confederaciones CONCACAF y CONMEBOL. En actividades confederales, esto está ligado a los derechos de televisión o de marketing de las competiciones en la CONCACAF o en la CONMEBOL, y especialmente este contrato supradimensional para la Copa América 2016. Entonces, la justicia americana interviene en este caso. Pero las elecciones en las diferentes confederaciones y las federaciones mismas, la FIFA no tiene influencia, especialmente no en las confederaciones, porque las confederaciones están independientes. El presidente de la FIFA tampoco puede elegir representantes de confederaciones en mi gobierno. Entonces yo el presidente de la FIFA, si no cambiamos los estatutos, está siempre una situación que en Francia se dice cohabitación, porque él, elegido del Congreso, debe construir con un gobierno que no es. Eso es la explicación.
Es feo porque parece que después de 40 años entonces usted no tiene ninguna responsabilidad en las relaciones que se han creado. La FIFA es una institución en la que se han creado relaciones. Usted con el doctor, con el señor Grondona ha tenido, por ejemplo, una relación muy estrecha y así ha podido construir lo que hoy es la FIFA. ¿Usted no siente tener ninguna responsabilidad?
Sí, yo admito que soy responsable. Al Congreso de 2015, cuando yo dije que acepto con placer de estar como presidente y yo quiero tomar la responsabilidad de todo que ha hecho al frente del Congreso, pero debe compartirlo, y yo lo presento, con el comité ejecutivo de la FIFA. En ese momento la mayoría de esos comités era siempre en plazo. I just want to repeat one thing. This gentleman from was speaking about the all people in South America, in CONMEBOL and CONCACAF. I have said that they have been arrested by especially, not specially, by actividades, the activities in their confederations, and we have no influence in the confederations. So he said, but you should have some, you must bear some responsibility. And you remember that at the Congress this year, at the election, I have said, and I repeat that, I take this responsibility, but not alone. I have to share it with my executive committee. And this executive committee at that time was already amputated by three or four, and now that's still amputated by other persons, which I have not had. I cannot be morally responsible. Last question.
Very last question.
Don't I really?
One more. This one, yeah.
Écoutez, c'est une très bonne question et c'est avec plaisir que je réponds à cette question sans passion. Bien sûr que j'ai eu envie de temps en temps de faire autre chose, mais je suis tellement lié à cette FIFA depuis maintenant plus de 40 ans, et les jours où j'ai vu que la FIFA est attaquée, elle était attaquée ce 27 mai de cette année, c'était une attaque à la FIFA, où on présentait la FIFA comme une organisation mafiosa, j'ai dû prendre mes responsabilités, c'est là que j'ai dit, pour protéger la FIFA, je mets mon mandat à disposition. Mais bien sûr, et je l'ai dit tout à l'heure aussi, j'aurais dû m'arrêter après la Coupe du Monde de 2014. Ça aurait été peut-être sage, mais on ne peut pas refaire l'histoire. Je suis là maintenant, je suis avec un compagnon depuis des années. Monsieur Michel Platini, il était déjà au tirage au sort pour la Coupe du Monde de l'Italie. Il s'occupait de la RAI, donc on l'a rencontré depuis longtemps. Et maintenant, avec lui, nous sommes dans une situation qu'on ne mérite pas et qu'elle est exactement fausse comme elle a été interprétée. Alors, mais ça ne sert à rien d'avoir des regrets. Et comme je dis, je me battrai jusqu'au bout. Merci. Ladies and gentlemen, I would like to thank you for your interest. I will not speak about my health, but at a certain time, I would tell you on the 1st of November, without a big help. A big help of la faculté de médecine, a big help from somebody, we wouldn't be here today. We wouldn't be here. But thanks to the faculté, thanks to God, thanks also to my, let's say, Valais origin, a lot of good genes.
Good heart.
I'm still, what?
Good heart,
okay. Thanks to my good heart, and I have never lost my mind. And today they told me, Mr. Blatter, now it is practically, sorry to say, but you are really, really nearby. I said, no, I want to go home, just to say that for my health. But I am back, I am doing better. I have the support of my daughter, I have the support of Linda, my love, and I have the support still from a lot of people inside the FIFA and members of the Executive Committee of FIFA, and they share with me, and also European members, they share with me that what has happened today is not the correct way to deal inside FIFA. And I repeat, it is an inside FIFA matter. I deny any American influence on this matter. Thank you again, and thank you for supporting the FIFA, because they are working well all around the world. Without president, actually, but I'll be back. Thank you.
This is the primary audio circuit for the Reuters live service. This is the primary audio circuit for the Reuters live service. This is the primary audio circuit for the Reuters live service. This is the primary audio circuit for the Reuters live service. This is the primary audio circuit for the Reuters live service.